The moment you receive your blood test with an elevated cholesterol level, you might immediately feel like you're at risk of atherosclerosis or cardiovascular diseases, like heart attack or stroke. You might assume that a cholesterol-free or very low cholesterol diet is essential to bring your cholesterol back down to normal. However, a cholesterol-free diet is not a wise option, and a very low cholesterol diet is not an effective strategy for managing blood cholesterol in most people with elevated levels. In this video series, we present three reasons why a cholesterol-free diet is generally unnecessary for preventing atherosclerosis and may actually be detrimental to your health. Before we begin, remember to hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up if you're ready to explore with us. All right, let's get started. First, the cholesterol in your food does not directly convert to the cholesterol in your blood. Many people believe that eating high cholesterol foods, such as eggs, shrimp, and full-fat yogurt, directly raises their blood cholesterol levels, but the reality is more complex. To understand the relationship between the cholesterol in your food and the cholesterol in your blood, it's necessary to know how the human body produces cholesterol. Cholesterol is a waxy, fat-like substance found in every cell of our body. The primary building block for cholesterol synthesis is acetyl coenzyme A, a molecule derived from the breakdown of carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. This synthesis is initiated with acetyl coenzyme A and supported by two essential components: NADPH, nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, and ATP, adenosine triphosphate. NADPH is a coenzyme that provides the reducing power needed for the biosynthesis of cholesterol. ATP supplies the energy required for the various reactions in the cholesterol synthesis pathway. This intricate process illustrates that the cholesterol you consume in food does not directly correspond to the cholesterol level in your blood. Instead, your body's internal production and regulation play a significant role in maintaining cholesterol levels. The human body is a sophisticated system that produces most of the cholesterol found in your blood. Cholesterol levels in peripheral tissues are regulated by a balance of uptake and export. While most cells can synthesize cholesterol, the majority is either ingested or synthesized by hepatocytes and transported in the blood to peripheral cells. The liver produces about 75% of the body's cholesterol. Additionally, under normal conditions, brain cholesterol remains separate from peripheral cholesterol because dietary and hepatic cholesterol do not cross the blood-brain barrier. Instead, astrocytes, a type of glial cell that constitutes the majority of cells in the central nervous system, produce and distribute cholesterol within the brain. This means that only a small portion of your blood cholesterol comes from the food you eat. Moreover, when dietary cholesterol intake increases, the liver typically compensates by producing less cholesterol to maintain balance. Cholesterol in food is often accompanied by other dietary fats, such as saturated fats and trans fats, which are ingested simultaneously. Understanding the distinction between cholesterol and other dietary fats can clarify why a cholesterol-free diet is unnecessary. Saturated fats and trans fats, found in foods like red meat, full-fat dairy products, and processed snacks, have a much greater impact on raising blood cholesterol levels than dietary cholesterol itself. These fats affect your blood cholesterol levels in two ways. First, saturated and trans fats can prompt your liver to produce more cholesterol, leading to an increase in blood cholesterol levels. Second, liver cells have LDL, low-density lipoprotein, receptors. When LDL cholesterol circulates in the blood, these receptors capture and remove the cholesterol, transporting it into the liver for breakdown. Research suggests that excessive consumption of saturated fat can impair the function of these receptors, causing cholesterol to build up in the blood. Another important aspect of dietary cholesterol is that people respond differently to it due to genetic factors. Some individuals, known as hyperresponders, may experience a more significant increase in blood cholesterol levels when they consume cholesterol-rich foods. However, even in these cases, the increase in LDL cholesterol is often balanced by an increase in HDL, high-density lipoprotein, cholesterol, which can help mitigate cardiovascular risk. Approximately 1 in 250 individuals has a genetic mutation for the LDL cholesterol receptor that leads to familial hypercholesterolemia, FH. This condition affects about 1.3 million people in the US, including children, but only about 10% are aware they have it. The good news is that familial hypercholesterolemia is treatable with medications and lifestyle changes. In summary, the cholesterol in your diet is not directly converted to cholesterol in your blood. The liver's regulation, the impact of other dietary fats, individual genetic factors, and the essential role of cholesterol all contribute to this complex relationship. The biggest influence on blood cholesterol levels is the mix of fats and carbohydrates in your diet, not the amount of dietary cholesterol you consume. Instead of focusing on eliminating dietary cholesterol, aim for a balanced diet that supports overall heart health. As we mentioned at the beginning of this video, atherosclerosis in your arteries is a key concern. Our discussion on the necessity of a cholesterol-free diet is aimed at preventing cardiovascular diseases caused by atherosclerosis. In our upcoming videos, we will take a closer look at atherosclerosis, cholesterol, and the primary culprits behind vascular diseases. We will also explore why and how cholesterol is essential to life. Stay tuned. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to leave them below. If you found this video helpful, we'd appreciate it if you could like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.